players that are in the middle of engagements hoping he can get anything
off. You
gotta
go!
And he just waited.
Waited way too long. The zone takes him down. Now down to just 19 players left. Tfue and Cloakzy both still alive. Cloakzy only with 62 HP in total. Nice job blocking those shots at the moment. The next zone about to begin now, as it looks like Tfue's in another build battle. And you see, in this build battle, Cloakzy stops for a second to try to help knock down his opponent, to give Tfue any help he can get in that engagement. They're back on the high ground again, and Cloakzy's turn now to take this role and just shoot down on any unsuspecting enemy. Like this.
What a shot. X's from Trouble Boys goes down.
They're
to
always
shotgun.
Up top. It is nuts, man. They are always one layer above. Look at this.
There we go, the top down. The advantage there is so substantial because as players are building up to try and get a height advantage mid-fight, if Tfue and Cloakzy already have it, five players left. Bravo and Barnal just going down the zone there.
Vilex and Jaganza, I believe, at the high ground now. That
Dots
should be
gets
Tfue.
The knock and Tfue, which means it's up to Cloakzy.
Six
to
grenades. Oh, good luck.
The chance here. Only a little bit, 10 builds left for Vilex.
Not a lot of mats.
Dropping grenades in, just anything. You notice he's dropping them ahead of a potential rotation in an effort to try and predict where his opponent's going to move to. Not throwing them directly at it. Vilex
Tfue and Cloakzy down.
The Elim. Nanolite gets the Elim there. There we go. Vilex, Jaganza.
Redemption
for the 1 HP. Redemption.
The game said,
feel good there.
You know what? One health last game, you nearly got it. This one, they get the victory royale, and just like that, they most likely stamp their ticket to Sunday as well. Brilliant stuff from them. That concludes the action here from Heat number one. Down to the wire, some of those games. That one was really as clean as it gets. Once they got the high ground, it was two of them. You saw Tfue and Cloakzy were stuck on low ground with not much help. Nanolite all by himself, you really can't expect much.
We saw a number of times these players taking high ground from each other. The swaps back and forth. There's Jaganza, Vilex. Just watch it from above.
Again, in the past, it's a strategy on the low ground. You just shoot that down. You knock them to their death.
Yep.
Now, you don't even care how. As you mentioned, they don't have to try to. Think of what we used to see, where they would mop the whole floor with floors and pyramids and block out.
Completely cover it.
Not the case anymore, because now they don't. The reason they would do that was so that it's not easy to get shot down.
It doesn't matter now.
Now they're just like, yeah, I'll put one little floor, shoot me down. I'll fall and be ready to fight.
Exactly. You can take a moment where you're trying to play defensively because of the glider redeploy mechanic. You can take someone being aggressive on you from underneath into an opportunity to push yourself and just land right on top of them. We've seen it a number of times. In that moment, Jaganza and Vilex decided to split. One dropped and the other remained up top to take shots on Tfue and Cloak as they were eliminated, and then the final team. And that kind of switch of gameplay, making an adjustment on the fly, man, you don't see that you don't see that in public matches.
No, not at all.
That doesn't happen in public matches. These competitive games, though, you see it every single time there's an engagement.
100%, 100%. And that, I think, sets the tone for the weekend. I've now seen four games with the glider redeploy. You definitely see how it makes a major impact, especially on those late game rotating zones. Instead of certain people only having bouncers, that gives them the ability to make these certain plays. Everyone's got the ability now. With the glider redeploy to make it happen. Man, I don't know, outside of a couple teams, who's even remotely in this top 10 or top 12.
It's gonna be a tight group. Plus, on top of that, whoever ends up in the 13th, you have an opportunity for a wild card movement into the finals, the grand finals on Sunday. So it's still anybody's game.
Yep.
The number of points that these players are securing too with very aggressive plays. We have the make it rain bonus as well, which was 20,000. This last game, it's insanity.
I think we have some quick little recap highlights to take a look at before we get our standings ready for you all. Here again, this is from the entire Heat 1, a look back at what we saw. It all began with Tfue and Cloakzy. They had the first couple of limbs of the day, and they set the tone for what they were going to bring to the table throughout the rest of the action.
Now you watch these clips, and you watch the accuracy of some of these shots, and just how efficient they are at catching players off guard right here, even Tfue. At some point, acid.
They just put themselves in like the worst place ever. You're stuck in the back of a truck.
Shooting fish in a barrel, man.
Anytime I've been stuck there in life, it's never been good. So as Sorn and Mowgli, we saw this fight earlier on. It was one wall. It was like both teams fighting over one edit ability. And you see just how crazy it is.
5, 6.
I think we're doing well. Make it rain. You're not keeping track of the limbs you're getting. You're just like, oh, we just somehow won an extra 10 grand. This is great.
At that point, they're going to be dug too deep into the gameplay and positioning and paying attention to what's happening to even consider the option that maybe I might have more eliminations than anybody else during this specific circle movement.
100%. As everyone else still looking on, wondering where their placement is, will they make it into the coveted top 12 to make it to Sunday? When they make it top 12, immediately, they've already won $5,000 each because every team gets paid out in the finals on Sunday in some capacity. The question is, can they earn themselves more in that competition? We will have 48 teams in total, and then the two wildcard teams that will be randomly selected from their 13th, spots. And in the coming moments, we should have our placements revealed as well, as I'm sure many people will breathe a sigh of relief when that comes on in if they made it to that top 12.
Sunday's going to be a big day for a lot of people, like you're talking about. $400,000 for the first place duo. The top three duos
Yep. Come
away with six-figure prizes still. And everybody gets a little bit at the end there, Tfue and Cloak.
Again, they wait and see.
Just hanging out, just waiting.
They made it. Boom.
The victory royale.
Victory royale. They know they qualify. They're good to go. Tfue, he's not
Cloak,
surprised.
We'll see on Sunday.
Tfue's like, okay, did my job. I'm going to go into a sauna and eat chicken wings.
Jack,
or is that what I want to do?
That's what you're doing immediately following the cast. That's,
yeah,
that's actually where your meet and greet is, by the way.
It's sauna.
In a sauna eating chicken wings.
Wow. Honestly, I'm sure my viewers would love it. There again, you see more of the hype right there, realizing they've made it. Those who didn't, though, fantastic games. There's more opportunities in the future, I'm sure. Enjoy the rest of the weekend here at TwitchCon. But we'll go ahead and get the full standings list here so
Let's
you can take a look.
Heat
first
standings.
Place, not even close.
15
not
points.
Even close.
What a lead.
Wow.
The team from Atlantis, 5 points behind. 20 eliminations between the two of them, which is, that is an insane number still. 20 eliminations.
And what's crazy is it was 10 points for Tfue and Cloak and 9 points for Hero, the Hero players, at the end of game two. They stay at 9. But again, we mentioned DK, the one great victory royale, 4 points. Enough to put them on up there.
All the way up into 10.
Devious and Frosty, they have one big game. Korea and Nibs, they have one big game. 5 points, they're on in as well. Jaganza and Vilix, you know that last game soared them right up the list.
Oh, absolutely.
So there you go, the full look. Super Evan and Godnik, Jebber and Left Eye, DK and TJ, the General and Vicarios, Frosty, Devious, Nibs, Korea, CBK Flame to FPS, Mowgli, Sorn, Vilix, Jaganza, Hero, JDW, and Hero Ronin. The Atlantis boys, and then Tfue and Cloakzy. Congratulations, you've made it to the grand finals on Sunday, where we will have one team in the top spot that'll walk away with $400,000 and the title of champions of the Fall Skirmish.
Now, don't forget that 13th place team, whoever that happens to be. Of the four heats, you still have that wild card position. They
yes.
can make it into Sunday, so the adventure might not be over just yet.
I believe we have... the wild card.
So
okay,
the team
wild card
Ghost.
Team from 13th is Ghost Kayun and Ghost Sean. So they're the ones that
they may or
they
may
wait
not
in the
have
wings.
Made it. Yeah,
they wait in the wings, and they'll find out with us if they've made it to Sunday. That's a scary duo.
That's a lot
as
of
well.
Tension right there.
That's
too.
A scary
oh,
duo.
Yeah.
So we know how good the Ghost organization has been so far in Fortnite. No surprise to see them right there. Will they wind up making it on in though? Is the question. So for now, we know our wild card team that we'll wait and see if they wake it on in. We know our 12 that are guaranteed in. Now we take a little bit of a breather. We wind up taking about probably a couple hour break here, I think it is, and then
yep.
or an hour break. We're 40 minutes late for our meet and greet. Everyone hates us now, but
absolutely, it'll
fine.
Be all right though.
It's fine. We'll make it work.
It's the way of the road, Jack.
It is okay. The way of the road. Tim, I'm wondering. Tim's way of the road is Tim the Tatman. His luggage was lost.
You hate to see that, although he was still had flip-flops on last night.
Yeah,
which doesn't
flip-flops
surprise
and socks,
anyone.
Which was what a cool sight that
He's
was.
He's dressing for the dad role already,
oh,
Jack.
Brilliant, brilliant stuff from him. As we'll wait final word on where exactly we're going to go next here. For me, though, fun first start to the weekend. Looking forward to seeing where things go next.
Only a little bit, a portion of the way through. Like you said, Heat 1 completed. We have our second, I believe that starts at 2:30 p.m. Pacific time.
Okay.
Is when that's scheduled. Now, correct me if I'm wrong. We had the schedule up earlier. And then, like you said, Heat 3 and 4. Jack and I won't be casting tomorrow, but I hope you enjoy the show then. Then we have the Streamvitational
yep.
on Sunday, which we have, there's some surprises in store for that, too. And then the Grand Finals. On Sunday, these players are hungry to get to that point.
We're getting set for an interview right now with Tfue and Cloakzy. We'll have it here in a moment. Sorry, I was waiting on word from production, but either way, you know, these guys came in, they did their job, they got that first place spot. I'm sure for them in this interview, they're going to basically say, we did it,